Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those who are new here, my name is Courtney and I'm here with my mom Michelle. Hi. And we're heading over to Animal Kingdom today, so come join us. Here we are.
We're here.
You have to be staying on a Disney resort to be on this side. Keep your party together in the same line, please.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you.
Thank you.
Same party?
Yes. Everyone's gonna go to Pandora, so I wanna go on Everest.
Okay. I think you don't wanna do Pandora first and get it over with?
I'd rather get a pass for it.
Oh, okay.
Is everyone ready for safari?
Yeah!
Nice. Now we'll ask them, please keep your hands, arms, feet, legs tucked at all times. Do not stand in the midst of children. This is not Lion King. And no disturbing noises. I want the animals to get as close up as possible. If you take a look up that panel of animals, those of the animals may potentially see today. Of course, I point out every single one I see. Do we have any first-time safaris here? Congratulations, it's not my first safari, so we're gonna have some fun. And everyone else, welcome back. Let me know how I am compared to the other drivers. I'm just kidding, don't do that, it'll hurt my feelings. We're just waiting on this light turn on, we can head into the reserve. As of right now, we're headed into the Little Lituri Forest. This is where animals will use light browns and dark browns as a way to camouflage. First animal will be on our right. It is an okapi.
Oh, yeah,
look. Okapis are often mistaken for relatives of the zebra because of their striped legs. They're actually the closest relatives to giraffes. They have the face of a giraffe, tongue of a giraffe, and ossicles just like a giraffe, which is skin-covered horns.
Wow.
And these lighter brown antelopes on our right are called greater kudus. These are females because only males grow horns in the greater kudu family. If you want to see what my greater kudu horns look like, you can find them on the panel of animals. They're very beautiful. They grow 6 feet long and they twirl from the base all the way to the tip. On our left is where the black rhinos live. Most people do not know the difference between black and white rhinos. It's not the color. They're both gray. It's actually just the weight lip difference. We are now entering into the Safi River, so we may find animals such as hippos and crocodiles. There they are. Good morning to the hippos. Despite hippo size, hippos actually only eat about 85 pounds of vegetation a day, which isn't much compared to any other animal their size, but it does make sense because all they do is relax in the water all day. Crocodiles are also known to be very good parents. The mother and father will take turns cradling the egg in their mouth to soften the shell before hatching. That way, whenever they do hatch, it's almost effortless. Always paint a good picture for the crocodiles. We all know if they are. We know if they do. Evil lizards. I don't know if we have any Lion King fans on the truck today. Coming up on our right is a baobab tree. In The Lion King, Rafiki is the mandrel that holds up Simba on Pride Rock at the beginning of the movie. He actually lives in a baobab tree. Most people don't know that. Baobab tree is also called the tree of life or the upside down tree. It's called the upside down tree because it's leafless 9 months out of the year instead of having leaves 9 months out of the year like a regular tree. But it's leafless 9 months out of the year that way it can hold and conserve its water. And it holds and conserves thousands of gallons of water. And in a drought, animals of the savannah will come and chew on the bark of the baobab tree to get that water out, which potentially saves their lives. Hence the name, Tree of Life. Also, that huge tree in the middle of Animal Kingdom, that is also a baobab tree. Most people don't know that because it's just mainly referred to as the Tree of Life. Unless you're in the savannah. And on our left are some Maasai giraffes. Maasai giraffes grow 18 to 20 feet tall. They get the least amount of sleep out of any animal in the world. They only sleep 30 minutes a day. Whenever giraffes run, they can clear 14 feet with one stride. And coming up on our right is a Hartman's Mountain zebra. These zebra have a little dewlap on the bottom of their neck, which is just a flabby piece of skin, and that is how they regulate the body temperature. Just like our very own fingerprint, every zebra has their very own print. They're all unique, so a baby zebra will memorize its mother's print right at birth. We would never lose her in a herd. And a herd of zebras called a dazzle, because it's so dazzling and aesthetic. I love it. On our right is a wildebeest. Wildebeests are the world's largest herding animal, other than humans. They gather at the Great Migration, which is a herd of about 1.5 million wildebeest. Then they migrate 500 to 1,000 miles, which is the same as walking from Orlando to New York. Fun fact about wildebeest, whenever wildebeest stampede, they just close their eyes and run as fast as they can, so they hit each other all the time. One way they make sure this doesn't happen is by going to sleep in all different directions. And if you rewatch Lion King, I want you to watch the scene whenever the wildebeest stampede through the valley and take out Mufasa. I want you to look at their eyes, you'll notice that they're closed. It's pretty cool, as far Easter egg. Also on the top of the hill on our right are some springbok. They're very small, they only grow to 3 feet tall, but they can jump 6 feet in the air and 13 feet forward while running. To put it into perspective, if they wanted to jump in the truck, they just effortlessly could. Luckily, that has never happened. On our right is the world's largest animal, a male African elephant. Male African elephants grow to 13,000 pounds. They can hold 5 gallons of water in their trunk at one time, and their skin is very sensitive. Their skin is so sensitive that if a mosquito bites them, it'll feel like a bee sting. We're now headed into the red clay pits. This is where elephants will come and dig their tusks in clay and eat it because it has many essential minerals they need. It's very delicious and nutritious for them, and as you can see on the right, there's been some elephants here. One way elephants will establish dominance with each other by playing a little game it's called trunk wars. It's whenever they wrap their trunks around each other's trunks and play a little game of tug of war. It's super simple, whoever pulls who wins, but it's super fun to watch. Who doesn't want to watch a 13,000 pound animal play tug of war? It's like the most intense game of tug of war there could ever be. I've seen him play trunk wars a couple of times and the guests always start freaking out. They're like, it's way too aggressive. Where's the keeper? The keeper needs to stop them. Like, the keeper is somewhere safe. We do not get involved in trunk wars. It'd be very dangerous. We just let it happen and enjoy the show. But I'm assuring you, it's very fun for them. And if any of them get hurt, I'm sure they have their very own reasons that we don't know about. It's sad that we don't speak elephant. Oh, Disney ducks. Up on our left are the white rhinos. Like I said before, they are larger rhinos. They weigh 5,000 pounds and they have the flat lips so they can graze grass. A group of rhinos is called a crash, and that is because they have very bad eyesight and won't see what's in front of them until it's about 5 feet away. Cheetahs are also the only big cat that will meow and purr, which is the main reason why I want a baby cheetah. He might roar.
Did a roar.
You'd only get that if you watched Shrek.
What a friend I made. It's
weird to
see one of them. It's just like a house.
Wow, look.
Whenever a lion roars, you can hear that roar for up to 6 miles. Coming up on our left are the warthogs. Warthogs are the world's largest burrowing animal. They're known for taking other animals' burrows, and whenever they go into their burrow, they back up into it with their tusks out in front in case they need to defend themselves, because they're very territorial animals. Look how good of manners he has. He eats on his knees. He's a poised warthog.
Oh my God, they're
my favorite to watch. Sometimes they'll start headbutting each other. I get to WDW commentator. I'd like from up top, and they headbutt each other. I love it.
Thank you. Oh my God, we just ran off the safari ride to make this reservation. Our table's ready. So cute. Oh, yeah. Ready?
Ah, that's a beautiful picture. Kisses, kisses.
Yeah.
Yes, we're gonna eat good.
Their day is made.
Can I smile?
Yeah. So good. Hog juice, it's like guava, orange juice, and
the Tusker has corn muffins, the zebra bread, look how cute. It's like a brioche.
Brioche bread.
Brioche bread, yeah, look how cute.
That's cute.
Leopards, and then the croissants.
And then you get Nutella, jam.
Butter, Nutella, and the strawberry jam.
And then some fruit and yogurt.
Fruit with yogurt, yeah. So nice. So nice.
Okay. And she got decaf English breakfast tea. You have to press the thing down.
Okay, English breakfast tea.
And I got coffee. And it's like a two-course meal. They bring it to your table. So here's like the fruit and the bread, and then they're gonna come back with waffles, eggs, like all the warm stuff. That's the butter.
Yeah. Because it's very hot out.
The bread's so cute. The little zebra. Is it sweet?
The one that I just ate, this one? No, very good butter.
Good. It's like deceiving. I think it's like a sweet bread. Which I would prefer. Like, I don't want a sweet bread.
It's not sweet at all.
That's the croissant yet.
I tried this one.
I think Nikki's coming around. I guess. Very good.
A little Nutella with my pineapple.
She's making fondue over here.
Mm. Very good. But I wasn't going to have any honey jar kale, but that Nutella makes me want to try it. There's chocolate colored anything is good. Don't cover.
Yeah. This is really good. The jelly's really good. I just had some.
Look at the strawberries in there.
Oh, it's strawberry? I thought it was raspberry.
I think it's strawberry.
No, I think it's strawberry. Yeah, very cool. Very good. Oh, here's Goofy. So cute. Hi, Goob! Yeah. Very nice. Yeah, the second round came. So we have Mickey waffles and Simba with some eggs. Was it sausage? Yeah, Simba waffle. And some home fried potatoes. And then I can't remember the name of
this. Curry. You said it was curry, right?
Oh, okay. Yeah, and that's hard boiled.
With the egg.
I actually want to try that. It looks really good. So cute. I haven't had Simba waffles in such a long time. I just tried this. This is very good. The curry. It is, I think, chicken, so like I've been moving that around, but the sauce itself with the hard-boiled eggs and the rice is very good. I'm a big fan of curry, so I like it.
Right, yeah.
It's very good. I haven't tried the like typical American breakfast yet.
Oh, I did. I'm like cleaning house on it. Love it, love it, love it. I'm an egg, bacon and egg girl.
Very good.
Thank you. We'll see what's next.
Hello.
How is it? You're number one.
Thank you.
Look, I have your girlfriend.
Hey guys, have a great day.
Enjoy this vacation, guys. Have fun, all right? Aw, so sweet. Don't cheat on her.
So what'd you think of breakfast?
Oh my god, it was so, it's a lot of food. It's all you can eat, but we couldn't do that. I liked it. I liked the presentation. Everything's so, you know, so pretty. Like the bread's looking like a zebra and a leopard with its spots. And the eggs were pretty good. I had the bacon. It was delicious. It was perfectly cooked. And I don't like sausage. I even eat a piece of, it's the flat, round sausage. I eat a piece of that. Very good. It was excellent. I loved it. The service was incredible. The characters are phenomenal. They come to every table, to every person, and spend a nice amount of time with you. They do photos and everything, so totally, totally worth it. If you have kids and a big kid like me, you know, I love it.
Yeah, I get awkward in character interactions, so I let her do all the talking.
Oh, I did it. I loved it. And I got to see Daisy, my favorite, because you never really get to see her, so that was awesome. She gave me kisses and hugs and big photos. That's the little characters.
But yeah, we're gonna head over to Pandora now and do Navi River Journey and Flight of Passage.
Okay, sealed genetic matching room. Okay, Dr. Stevens, they're ready.
Can everyone see me? Great. Welcome to the Avatar program. Soon, you're going to have a chance to undertake an amazing Navi rite of passage, flying on the back of this powerful animal called an Ikran, or as we call it, a Banshee. The way you're going to do this is by being matched to something called an Avatar, and I'm here to help you guys get ready. But first, we have to scan you for Pandoran microparasites. All right, everyone, stay on your number and move your arms a bit. Okay, start scan. You've all got them. But don't worry, they're very common around these parts. Let's start the decon.
Initiating GMR decon.
Stand still over your number, you're not gonna feel a thing. You're doing great. Almost done here.
They're all clear.
Great. Now let's go over how all this works. Like I said before, you're going to be matched to these things called avatars, which look a lot like the Na'vi. They're created by blending human DNA and Na'vi DNA. Once we match you to an avatar, thanks to a special link chair, your mind will be able to control that avatar. Using avatars to fly this way was all figured out by my boss, Dr. Jackie Ogden. She leads her science team, which is part of the Pandora Conservation Initiative, and we're here in the Valley of Moara studying banshees and their environment. Over a generation ago, this enormous company called the RDA created a lot of damage to the area through their bad mining practices and conflicts with the Na'vi. Just like on Earth, it can take decades for ecosystems to recover. One way to understand what's going on with an ecosystem is to study what are called keystone species. These are animals like tigers, jaguars, seals. The banshee is one of these important animals. Dr. Ogden is the foremost expert on studying the Ikron and has spent years researching them. Unfortunately, banshees live high in rookeries and humans can't get anywhere near them without becoming their lunch. But the Na'vi and avatars can. In fact, the Na'vi have been riding on the backs of banshees since their earliest history. Thanks to science, avatars can ride on banshees too. That's why you're linking to an avatar. Okay, to get you flying on a banshee, we need to find each of you an avatar. Let's prep the genetic sampling.
I'm on it.
Okay, first we need to find the compatible match of your genetic material with the genetic material of one of the avatar bodies that we already have. Once we do that, you'll be able to link to that avatar and fly. Help us out and move around a bit. Almost. Yes, got it. Now, let's find you your avatar matches. All right, you've all been matched with avatars.
Thank you.
like, I'm glad they added the water back.
Yeah.
A little refreshing. But yeah, it's so nice. We're gonna head over to Navi River Journey, which is like the boat ride. Mm-hmm. Remember the hurt our grandmother?
Yeah.
So yeah, that's another relaxing one. And then I think we might call it a day after that, but we'll see what happens. It's just a little too hot today. You do not need another one.
Oh my god, I'm sorry.
You do not need another one. It's the Banshee.
I wish it was smaller. I like them small.
Oh, how cute is that, Courtney?
It's the blankie, you unbutton it.
Oh my god, that's
incredible. I can't. Oh my god, such a child.
That's a pretty color.
Yeah. Ooh, Alec would like this.
Oh yeah.
Good.
Look at these cups, they're so cute.
They are.
I like that they don't have a handle. It says Flight of Passage on the back. Let me drop it. Oh, they have fanny packs?
This one's smaller? This one's
smaller. I kind of like this.
That's nice. This one's smaller.
Welcome. For your safety, please remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside.
Thank you.
So I think that's it, right? Like,
I think that's it.
Yeah, well, we did pretty good.
We've done everything.
Yeah. So we rope dropped. We got how many rides? I think four, right?
Yeah.
Oh, no. No, yeah, four. Yeah, four plus breakfast.
Yeah, we gotta head back.
So I think we're gonna head back to the hotel because we have Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party tonight.
Yeah, gotta get ready.
And us little grandmas, we have to stay up till midnight, so. Yeah, and it's getting a little too hot right now.
Hi.
Oh, you're so cute. Here's an answer, give me one. One of your answers, dude.
You're so cute. Bye.
Alright, so that's gonna be it for today's video. We did pretty good. We got like all the main rides done before noon. And we're gonna head back to the hotel and do Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party later tonight. So that'll be in the next vlog. Stay tuned for that one. If you did enjoy this video, please feel free to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more weekly content. And until next time, bye. Is it one?
Yeah.
Oh my god.